And joining me exclusively tonight on the 9 o'clock news is the man whom the Delhi police reports to, the Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, Mr. Tejinder Khanna. Mr. Khanna, thank you so much for joining me. I'll also be joined in just a few minutes from now by Mr. Arun Jaitley, Leader of Opposition in the Rajya Sabha, and of course, a keen Dilliwala and a lawyer as well. But let me go across first, Mr. Tejinder Khanna. Mr. Khanna, we heard the Home Minister say in Parliament today that intelligence was given to the Delhi police in July of a possible attack on the High Court. And we know, of course, that May, the explosion that happened in May here, was being seen as a virtual dry run now by intelligence agencies. What happened? Was this a huge failure on the Delhi police, the Delhi administration's part?
Well, let me only say that even the last time when it happened, it was outside the boundary wall of the court and the secured premises of the Delhi High Court. This time again, it has been actually next to the Sher Shah Suri Marg entrance of gate number 5. Lots of people were gathered in queue to seek their entry passes into the High Court premises. And basically, there is police within also. There was general sort of patrolling and all going on. But I have always maintained in every single Republic Day address since I took charge that foremost priority is our security environment, and citizens of the capital also have to remain a little extra alert. It's not a Mufassil town.
No, but besides the people of Delhi, Mr. Khanna, the question is that actual intelligence. The Home Minister says intelligence was given to the Delhi police in July. So that's not something which the people of Delhi are responsible for. What about what the Delhi police should have done in response to this?
No, on this I'll only say that in all my discussion with the police commissioner, what happens is we keep on saying, have you received any actionable intelligence? You see, one intelligence would be of a general nature saying that this is a period when you might expect a possible strike. Right. And we all know that in about a month or so preceding all national events like Independence Day, Republic Day, yeah, the police goes on very high alert and they maintain a very kind of heavy duty patrolling on the streets and general security preparedness and so on and so forth alert. So one becomes a more general kind of alert which is provided by the IB,
yes,
saying that this is a possibility that strikes may occur.
Yes.
The other is a very specific thing that they think a particular module from mm-hmm. some agency which has come to their attention may be planning a targeted strike at some location.
Right.
For instance, whether it's Parliament House or Red Fort or it's a particular target that is in view.
Yes. So you're saying, sir, basically that this intelligence was not actionable intelligence? This was a general warning? It wasn't actionable?
It was not, to my mind, anything specific, because I get my information really from the police commissioner, and they regularly attend daily meetings of the multi-agency center MAC established by the Home Ministry,
right,
under our distinguished Home Minister's leadership. And the multi-agency center is supposed to collate information from all information agencies which are collecting intelligence, whether it's military or civil,
yes,
and then they share it with the Delhi police, of course, we are the national capital, plus others also who may be concerned.
Yes.
And no such information has ever been shared with me saying that specific intelligence has been received. In fact, they have been saying basically that in the last several weeks it's been more general and nothing very specific that they can begin to tail.
Right.
And, track down further.
Right. Well, the Home Minister's statement in Parliament has been received very differently by people who heard that. But just to ask, forget about the intelligence for a moment. We couldn't have got a bigger warning than the fact that there was a dry run, a rehearsal, which in May, when there was a much less serious explosion at the Delhi High Court. After that, what steps had been taken? The former Chief Justice, Justice AP Shah, has pointed out that there are no CCTV cameras at the High Court as well, even now.
No, this we'll have to, of course, check with the Delhi police, because installation of cameras at vulnerable sites is something they are obliged to be undertaking.
Mm-hmm.
And there have been some decisions where they have covered something like 54 markets and various entry points and places of a lot of public congregation. But I think the Delhi High Court was not among the 54 so listed in the initial sanctions which were approved. But I'll check these details with the Delhi Police Commissioner also. And of course, we have been saying that we should have an entire city-wide coverage and do it at one go,
yes,
rather than piecemeal. And we need to really obviously expand that coverage much more than currently is in place.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.